हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई प्रभा शर्मा वेलकम यू टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ द जर्नल। दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ द जर्नल बिकॉज नाउ डेज यू आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द न्यूमेरिकल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द जर्नल फर्स्ट। नाउ द टाइप्स ऑफ द जर्नल एंट्रीज एंड हाउ टू प्रिपेयर द जर्नल एंट्रीज। नाउ फर्स्ट द टाइप्स ऑफ द जर्नल एंट्रीज आर डिवाइडेड इंटू टू पार्ट्स। नंबर वन सिंपल एंट्री एंड सेकेंड इज द कंपाउंड एंट्री। Compound means combined entry. Now simple entry means when a one transaction takes place. Listen again, the one transaction take place. It is consisted with the two nature of accounts. One is debited, another is credited. It means with the one transaction, two accounts are listed. Combined entry is reference to when the transactions are more are combined in one. It means one transactions two account affected. And the second is when transactions are done in combinedly, two or more transactions are done when the date are same, that means then combined entry can be passed. Only then the items on the debit side can be more and the credit side may be less, or the item may be the accounts can be affected to the both side with the different number of accounts. So this is called as combined entry. And now the first of all, now use of the rules of debit and credit. Now I am starting how to pass the journal entry. This is the basic chapter. If you are going to understand very clearly, only then the other chapters will help you to do very smoothly the task, because this is the base chapter, should understand on the basis of the principles called as double entry system, rules of debit and credit. I am taking here the format of, this is the format. You may say the date particulars, LF, debit amount and credit amounts are listed here. So when the date is listed here, we have to write down the date. And then the particular is the one journal entry is listed, and in the bracket you may see the narration is given of the transactions listed. And the LF word is, you don't have to fill, but it is reference to the ledger page number. What do you mean by the ledger page number? After the journal entry, you have to understand the ledger chapter, and then this is referring to the page number of ledger. And now the debit amount means the amount of the, if debit side cash is listed, debit amount is listed. So the debit amount to be listed in front of the cash. If the X is listed on the credit side, then the amount credit is to be listed in front of X. So this is the just format I have discussed with you. And at the end, you may see the money invested in the business also listed. This is called as narration. Now I am moving to one by one the transactions related with journal entry. Number one is the when X invest 2 lakh into the business as a owner. This is the business of X now. How to pass the journal entry? At the top, you have to write down the word journal entries, or you may write down the word journal. So this is the first entry when X invested the money into the bank, into the business. Business is receiving the money and the cash is asset. It will be debited. And 2X means the X is the owners, and the owners investment is to be called as capital, and the capitals will be credited. So here the word is referring to the cash account debits to X capitals. So the next one is purchase goods for cash. When the goods purchase for cash, goods are coming inside the business. So that's why the when goods are coming, it will be referred with the name of purchase. If sold, then it will be referred with the sale. So the when goods is coming, the purchase account will be debited because it will increase the stock, you may say. And then for cash, cash is moving out. In the both cases, you may say the one asset is increasing and the second asset is decreasing. And now third is the goods sold for cash. When the goods sold for cash, the cash is coming inside the business. That is the part of asset is increasing. So it will be listed with the cash account debit. And the second is the goods sold. You may say the stock is decreasing now. Stock is also the part of asset, you may say. So that means the next asset is decreasing with the name of sale. So the in this also, the one asset is increasing and another asset is decreasing. But in the some cases, the purchase and sale can be considered purchase as expense and the sale can be as a revenue. In the same cases, the answers will be same. So now I am moving to the next journal entries. The journal entry refers to the machinery purchase for cash. When the machinery purchased for cash, that is referring the asset noun. When asset is purchased, it should be listed in the journal entry with own name. So the machinery account is to be debited and the money is going out to cash. When the money is not going outside with cash, then the name of supplier will be listed here. So the you have to see what is coming and what is going out. So the machinery is coming, money is going. In the both cases, it is affecting to asset. Asset is with the name of machinery is increasing and with the name of cash is decreasing. Next is the machinery sold for cash. When machinery sold for cash, cash is coming, machinery is moving out. The both cases are asset. One asset is increasing with the name of cash and the asset machinery is decreasing with the name of asset. So that means the cash account is to be debited and to the machinery. And the value of amount is to be listed 12,000. The debit amount is to be listed in front of the debit and the credit amount is to be listed on the credit. In the same manner, other entries will be passed. But today my main focus is to pass the how to pass the journal entry. So I am focusing on the particulars columns. You should try to understand how to pass the entries. Now the October 5 is there. Purchase furnitures from Messrs. Ram. Now the word is not listed here for cash. So when the cash word is not listed, only the name of the supplier is listed. We have to suppose it is on credit. Furniture is coming, but the money is not moving outside. It is showing the liabilities towards the Messrs. Ram. So furnitures will be debited because the furniture is coming as a form of asset and increasing the business asset. And to the Messrs. Ram means it is liables to pay. Business is liables to pay to Messrs. Ram called as supplier. The name of supplier is to be listed. But in the same manner, if the furniture purchased from Messrs. Ram for cash, so you don't have to give the weightage to the Messrs. Ram when the dealing is in cash. Only when the dealing is on credit, only the name of person will take the place. Furniture sold to Sham. When it is to the Sham, it means it is on credit. Here the error is there in the entries. So you may correct it. When the goods sold to Sham, it will be the entries. The Sham account debit to furnitures. Because the it is a goods sold to Sham means the amount is receivable from Sham. The Sham will be a customer. So the entry will be passed like this. The Sham account debit to furnitures. You may change. This is by mistake has been written the furnitures to Sham. But again, I am moving to change this entry like furniture sold by Sham. So when I am talking about the by Sham, it means the business is purchasing. Then this entry will be correct. Either you may change the goods sold by Sham, then the entry is correct. If the entry we have to take, you have to write down the furnitures sold to Sham, then the entry will be the Sham to furnitures. So listen, the two aspects are there. You have to see only to the business. If the business is purchasing, then purchase entry will be passed. If business is selling, then sale entry will be passed. So I'm moving to the next. Then the paid rent for the residence. When the residence is there, it is the personal use for the businessman. So when it is for the personal use, then the drawings will be shown as debit. Drawing word means use for the personal use. Drawing word is for any item for the personal use, for the payment of son fees, for the marriage of any daughter, or maybe the other aspect related with the for domestic point of view, then the drawings will be debited. Then drawings to if paid rent is there, so we don't have to write down the rent as expense. Drawing word be listed here, and paid word is reference to cash. Money is moving out from the business. So, to cash means reducing asset. So, drawing, if it is a part of asset, it is increasing in the form of drawing, and the cash is as a asset is decreasing. So, both are the part of related with the drawings to cash. Now, the paid for stationery. Stationery is expense. So, the stationery is coming and the payment is moving out. So, the stationery account is debited and the cash will be credited. But the stationery is the part of expense. When it is coming, it is increasing in the business. And the cash is the part of asset is decreasing now. So the next is the rent received. When it is received, that means cash is coming in the business. Cash is increasing as a asset and debited. And the next is rent. When rent received, it is a revenue. When it is a revenue, revenue will be credited. So when it is increasing and when having in the organization, it will be credited. Now I am moving to the next example, how to settle the account of a one particular person. Now I have taken the three example here, like the goods sold to X. When the goods sold to X, the simple entry we have already informed you to pass X to sales account. When the goods sold to X, the goods returned by the X, that means again the giver is X. When the giver is X, it will be placed on the credit. Receiver will be on the debit, but the giver will be on the credit. But it is returns, because the goods sold is returns, so it is to be called as the sale return. So the sale return account debit and 2X. Now you may see on 10th October, goods sold with the 15,000. And the 11th is showing the goods returns to X with the 5,000. So what is receivable from X after 15 and the 5? You may have to observe only the X account. You don't have to pay the attentions now to settle the account with the sale and sale return. Only the focus, only the X account. X is debited, means receivable 15,000 and 5,000 return by credited the item. So the 10,000 he is now payable. It will be placed on the credit side first. How to close? First make the debit total of the X, then credit total of the X, and difference is to be put on the which is short by. Now you may see only the X is short by 10. First to place to the in front of X 10,000. This is receivable. And now settle of the X account is, that means full amount is to be received. So that's why in front of cash full amount is taken. But if full settlement is, if the less amount is received, then the write down in front of the cash and the rest will go to the discount. But you may see the debit total should be always remain equal to the credit. In the same manners, I'm taking the next example of the settlement of the accounts with the help of the purchase of goods. The purchase of goods, first entry is goods purchased from Y. Then we have passed the entry purchase to Y, as you know earlier also. Now the goods return due to the defective levels to the Y. That means now the Y is receiver of the goods from the business. So the Y account is debited. And then to purchase returns, means the goods purchase is debited. Now it is to be returns. So the level of the purchase is to be down with the name of returns to purchase returns with the amount of 5,000. And now you may have to settle the Y account. But before to settle the Y account, you may have to make the total of the credit side. The credit side in this question only the Y is listed one time. That is the total of the credit side 15,000. And debited with the 5,000 only. But if the number of entries are more, you have to make the total of the credit side as well as to the debit side. And the see the difference, which side is short. Here only the Y's debit side is short by the 10,000. So you have to place first the debit side to the Y 10,000. This is the system to close any account, settle any accounts. Then to settle with the payment now. To cash 10,000, because the question is not listed with the discount, so pay with the cash account. So the, here the entry will be settlement of, see the difference, and then place where is it short, and then to settle with the cash account. This is a complete discount, complete amount 10,000. If the less amount is paid, the rest of the part will go to the discount. So this is the angles. Now you may start with the journal entry from the back exercise also. And if there is any doubt, to be discussed. Thank you.